Today we're talking about the first piece of marijuana legislation to ever pass a part of Congress. We're really going into the weeds on this one. So what's in this joint resolution? Well, to be blunt, I don't want to get your hopes as high as the guy who proposed this bill. Colorado representative, of course he's from Colorado, Ed Perlmutter. This isn't the bill that legalizes marijuana. That bill does currently exist though and is, no joke, House Resolution 420. Nice. Wednesday, in a historic vote, 91 Republicans joined 229 Democrats to pass legislation that would finally give marijuana businesses access to banks. Many publications are saying that this might be a piece of gateway legislation that could lead some of the more moderate Republicans to dabbling in full-blown marijuana legalization. For marijuana advocates, this was a huge victory.
It's the first time lawmakers have ever voted on a marijuana bill.
That's true. This is the nation's first standalone cannabis reform legislation. Before we go into the solution, let's talk a little bit about the problem though. Weed regulation is weird in this country, because it's legal to varying degrees in some states, but very much illegal federally. The easiest way to think about it is, the federal government right now is that chill parent with the high school basement parties. Alright, so I know some of you are going to be drinking tonight, but just be safe. Don't drive and stay in the basement where it's kinda legal. Of course, that parent reserves the right to kick down the door and take away all of the lukewarm Pabst Blue Ribbon if things get too out of control. Because of this administrative sword of Damocles, any bank that provides services to a legal marijuana business might face possible criminal prosecution for aiding and abetting a federal crime and money laundering. This is, of course, contingent largely on how much chill the current Department of Justice head is. So, okay, maybe banks won't do business with the marijuana companies. What's the big deal? Well, things get bizarre very fast.
This is federal taxes that we pay in cash. Also our payroll, when we pay all 12 employees, they're getting envelopes of cash. These are state taxes, vendor payments that are due to go out for orders of other products like edibles.
Whew, that's a lot of cash. Now this first brings us to the obvious problem of, so you're just gonna walk that money into a bank? If I jumped you on the way there, I could retire comfortably. This wasn't a deceptively large amount of money either. One Nevada medical marijuana dispensary owner had $2 million in $20 bills being prepared for hand delivery to the Internal Revenue Service to pay taxes that the business cannot pay via bank. Man, they're paying taxes? That's the one benefit to going cash only. In fact, a new industry has emerged in states like Colorado entirely designed around protecting all this cash being driven around. Now this brings us to the slightly more involved problem that gets some representatives worried. That $9 billion that could be going into the economy is instead being stored in vaults.
And they might put it in a shoebox or a pillowcase in their closet. So they use us to transport it in our armored vehicles, and we have safe storage in our facility because the banks won't take it.
Bet you never thought you'd see an armored car with pot leaf decals. So banks aren't loaning that money out, it's just sitting there. With those problems in mind, congressional leaders got together to pass this bill that would shield banks from federal prosecution for serving marijuana businesses in states where the drug is legal. So there you have it, the Safe Banking Act. The one time in history you're going to get liberals pushing to deregulate the banks. Next step is the Senate, and surprisingly, with bipartisan support and Mitch McConnell's love of hemp as a cash crop in Kentucky, people are saying that this bill actually stands a pretty good chance of getting passed. Thank you and wow, this was a bit of a short episode, but hey, not everything I do has to be a Ken Burns documentary. I guess that's all I have to say about that. Oh, and don't do drugs. Hello YouTube. If you want to support independent, nonpartisan news, remember to subscribe by clicking on this floating logo to the right of my head. Ring that bell so that freedom will continue to ring, and give me a thumbs up if you like what you saw. Lastly, as always, thank you for watching.